Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. My dear respected elders, brothers, sisters, and the viewers of the Daily Reminder Network, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen, wa usalli wa usallimu ala ashrafil anbiya'i wal mursaleen, nabiyyina wa habibina wa qurrati a'yunina Muhammad ibn Abdullah, alayhi wa ala alihi wa ashabihi afdalu salati wa atamu taslim, amma ba'd. As always, we begin by praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who is our creator, sustainer, nourisher, protector, and curer. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to shower His choicest of blessings and salutations upon our beloved Master Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his family members, his companions, and all those who tread upon his path with utmost sincerity until the day of Qiyamah. MashaAllah, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless this gathering, and may He the Almighty make the malaika, the angels shroud us with their wings, and may the sakina, tranquility of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala descend upon us, and may He the Almighty envelop us with His rahmah, and may He make high mention of us in the seven heavens. InshaAllah ta'ala, for today's heart softener, we will be touching on Tadabburul Qur'an. Because sadly, even though we are in a month otherwise known as the month of Quran, many of us, including myself, we tend to neglect reading the Quran, reciting the Quran, let alone making tadabbur of the Quran. So what is tadabbur? Tadabbur is to ponder and reflect on the verses of the Quran. And what better an opportunity than to apply this in this beautiful month, otherwise known as the month of the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He states in the noble Quran, شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن. شهر رمضان, the month of Ramadan is in which أنزل فيه القرآن. The Quran descended in this beautiful month. So my dear respected elders, brothers and sisters in Islam, let us make use of this blessed month to make tadabbur of the Quran. Because after all, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also states in the noble Quran, أَفَلَا يَتَدَبَّرُونَ الْقُرْآنَ أَفَلَا يَتَدَبَّرُونَ الْقُرْآنَ. Do they not ponder on the Quran, on the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? أَمْ عَلَىٰ قُلُوبٍ أَقْفَالُهَا. Or have they got locks on their hearts? Allahu Akbar. Now you see how closely making tadabbur upon the Quran is related with an individual's heart. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He questions, do they not ponder on the words of the Quran? Or have they got locks on their hearts? Allahu Akbar. So if you cannot ponder on the Quran, that means your heart is sealed up. Allahu Akbar. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us all. After all, the heart of an individual, just as how Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu is reported to have said that the heart of an individual is like a king in his body, whilst the limbs of that body, they are the subjects of that king. For whatever the king commands, the subjects will abide and obey. And also he is reported to have said that the heart is like an army commander, and the limbs are its forces and troops. Whatever the army commander commands, the forces and the troops abide. And also, our beloved master Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is reported to have said much more beautiful words. Alawa inna fil jasadi mudgha. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is reported to have said that in an individual's heart there is a piece of flesh. إِذَا صَلُحَتْ صَلُحَ الْجَسَدُ كُلُّهُ. If that piece of flesh is upright, if that piece of flesh is proper, then the whole body is proper and only good will come out of that body. The narration goes along the lines of these words. But if that piece of flesh were to go bad, if that piece of flesh were to become evil, the whole body of an individual will become evil, will become corrupt, will become perverted. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us all. For if an individual's heart were to go bad, only evil would come out from that body. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us all to purify our hearts. Because the more we ponder on the powerful and beautiful words of our Maker, the more we will understand how great and how powerful a creator we are subject to. The more we ponder on the Quran, for the Quran is not just only for reading or only for listening, because Allah Himself states in the ayah I recited earlier, أَفَلَا يَتَدَبَّرُونَ. Do they not ponder? Because Allah could have said, do they not recite the Quran? Do they not hear the Quran? Nay, but rather He used the word tadabbur. Do they not ponder on the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? So like I said, the more we ponder, the more we will be able to understand the greatness of our Creator. The more we ponder on the ayat, say for example, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes Himself, Allahu la ilaha illa huwa al-hayyul qayyum. Allahu Akbar. Allah, there is no deity worthy of worship other than Him. Al-Hay, the ever-living, the eternal. Al-Qayyum, the one who sustains all of His creation. La ta'khudhuhu sinatun wa la nawm. Neither does sleep or even a tiny slumber ever overtake Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Our Maker is so powerful and so great. Hadith is in Muslim. Abu Musa al-Ash'ari radiyallahu anhu, he reports that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is reported to have said, Inna Allaha la yanam. Indeed, Allah the Almighty, He does not sleep. وَلَا يَنْبَغِي لَهُ أَنْ يَنَامُ. Nor does it befit His majesty and His glory that He should sleep. The narration goes along the lines of these words. يَخْفِذُ الْقِسْطَ وَيَرْفَعُ. He lifts the scales of things and He lowers them. يُرْفَعُ إِلَيْهِ عَمَلُ اللَّيْلِ قَبْلَ عَمَلِ النَّهَارِ. The deeds of the night go up to Him before the deeds of the day. And then the deeds of the day go up to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala before the deeds of the night. حِجَابُهُ النُّورِ. Allahu Akbar. The veil of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is made of light. Allahu Akbar. The veil of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is made of light. لَوْ كَشَفَهُ. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala were to ever remove that veil of His, لَأَحْرَقَتْ سُبْحَاتُ وَجْهِهِ مَنْتَهَا إِلَيْهِ بَصَرُهُ مِنْ خَلْقِهِ. Allahu Akbar, Allah save us all. If Allah the Almighty were to remove His veil, the light of the face of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would burn every single creation in the sight, in the path of the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And scholars explain that would mean that every single creation would burn to ashes, because nothing is hidden from the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nothing is ever, not even an atom, not even a molecule is hidden from the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So if Allah the Almighty were to remove His veil, the light of His face would burn every single thing other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala into ashes. This is how powerful our Creator is. The more we ponder on the Quran, the more we understand how great Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is. And the more we ponder on the Quran, the more we stand a chance to become from the Ahlul Quran. Allahumma ja'alna min ahli al-Qur'an. Oh Allah, make us from the people of the Qur'an. Make us so closely attached to the Qur'an that we recite the Qur'an earnestly, that we recite the Qur'an often. We live in modern times. I would say most of the gathering over here, 99.9%, all of us would have smartphones. And it is so easy to download the Qur'an applet onto our smartphones. But sadly, the question that we need to ask ourselves, do we open up the Facebook applet more? Do we open up the Twitter applet more? Do we open up the Instagram applet more? Or do we open up the Qur'an more? It is so facilitated, you don't have to carry the hard cover of the Quran everywhere. You have it as if as an application. Wherever you are, you can open it up and start reciting the Quran, so that we become people of the Quran. We become so closely attached to the beautiful words of our powerful Maker. There was an incident that took place in Cairo, and this was narrated by a scholar. This was an incident that took place in a hospital. The doctor narrates this incident to this scholar, a very reputed, notable scholar. There was once a Hafidhul Quran who had to undergo a surgery. He goes to the hospital, he meets the doctor. He's an elderly person, but a person who is extremely pious and very closely attached to the Quran. He goes and meets the doctor, asks about the surgery, and then the doctor informs that Hafidh that the surgery will take almost around 4 to 5 hours. The Hafidh al-Quran, he starts to cry and weep. The doctor, the surgeon, he says, "There's nothing to worry. Please don't worry. It's just a minor surgery. It will be over before you know it. And anyway, we are going to administer anesthetics. You won't even feel it. Why are you crying?" Then the Hafidh al-Quran, he explains, "I'm crying because today, if I were to undergo the surgery for 4 to 5 hours, I would miss my daily wird, my daily recitation of the noble Quran, Allahu Akbar." We, the Huffadul Quran, we should spend so much of time with the Quran. We should make a fixed amount of reciting, perhaps 3 chapters, 4 chapters, 5 chapters. And even the people who are not Huffadul Quran, they should also intend strongly to recite as much as possible from the Quran. So nevertheless, the patient, the Hafidh, then he says, "I have a request, doctor. Can you please give me 1 hour? Lay me on the table to perform the surgery. Give me 1 hour. Let me start reciting the Quran. After 1 hour, you come and you conduct your surgery and finish it off." The doctor, he says, "Of course, Allahu Akbar, by all means, I give you 1 hour. You recite the Quran. Me and my team will come and do the surgery after 1 hour. 1 hour, he's on the table, he's reciting the Quran, because after all, he is a Hafidh. He has memorized the Quran. He recites it beautifully out of his memory. Right after 1 hour, the doctor and his team, they enter the room and they start the surgery. The doctor, he informs this scholar, "Wallahi ya Shaykh, wallahi, the surgery took almost 4 to 5 hours. Throughout the surgery, even though we administered anesthetics, the patient, the Hafidh al-Quran, was reciting the Quran throughout the surgery." Allahu Akbar. He was reciting the Quran throughout the surgery. My dear respected elders, brothers and sisters in Islam, if we live with the Quran, we will die with the Quran. Because after all, pondering upon the Quran is closely connected to your heart. And this tongue of yours is the spoon that takes out what is in the heart. So if you have the Quran, if you have the love for the Quran in your heart, the love for the speech of your powerful and beloved Maker, even when death comes to you, leave alone a minor surgery, even when Malakul Maut comes and stands in front of you, nothing other than words that will please your Maker only will come out of your mouth. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us all from the people of the Quran. And I don't find it hard, or I don't find it difficult to believe that story, because I have a personal experience. Just a few weeks ago, my own beloved father had to undergo a small surgery. I took him to the hospital, and the doctor, he said, "We have to administer a very small, a general anesthetic, but the only issue is it is like a truth serum. The side effect is the patient might start to mutter things that are in his subconscious, so don't take notice of it." So the doctor, he administered the drug for my father, and after a while, my father, he started crying out all types of adhkar. Subhanallah, Alhamdulillah, Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah. That is, the minute I witnessed that, shudders and shivers ran down my spine. Because I was thinking, if I was in that place, I don't know what may come out from my mind. Because the things of our mind are all hidden. We show a different picture. But the secrets, those deep secrets are within us. So if we are truly sincere and close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even at a time like that, or even when Malakul Maut comes in front of you, only things that would please your Maker will articulate or will come out from your your tongue. So please, I implore, make use of this blessed month to ponder on the Quran, to make more and more recitation of the Quran, and to ponder on the words of our powerful Maker, resulting in us becoming close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and resulting in us making the best out of this month. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us all to ponder on His words, and may He the Almighty help us to make the best out of this month of Ramadan, and may He unite us in the gardens of Jannah, just as how He united us here tonight with our beloved Master Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وآخر دعوايا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين جزاكم الله خير سبحان الله بحمده سبحانك اللهم بحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك.